Hi, I'm Tony, Explore Crypto Channel, and in this video we will explore Muun Wallet, which is multi-signature Bitcoin wallet and non-custodial Lightning Network wallet based on submarine swaps. Let's start the video. So recently I was able to test the Muun Wallet on my mobile phone, and those are the informations that I got from those tests. So I will be summarizing them in this video. So basically the setup of the wallet was pretty easy. You just have to give up your email address, and there was no seed. So those are the two red flags for me. Using some Bitcoin services, I wouldn't like to give out my email. Of course, it's for the security, they are storing the keys in some kind of multi-sig scheme. But obviously, I would rather just have the wallet based on the seed and some kind of secure passphrase. This is what is working for me usually, but I get it that the user experience for the new users who would like to send some Lightning Network transactions, it's probably better for them just to give up their email address. So this is not a big deal. But there also wasn't a seed when I was initializing the wallet. There was no seed visible for me to write it down, to secure it in some way. So in my opinion, it's some minus points for that, but other than that, it's all well. So I basically just went to my receive tab to send myself 100th of the Bitcoin. I sent this Bitcoin to my Muun Wallet on chain, of course, and then I was able to create the transaction on the Lightning Network. So on my node, by the way, if you would like to connect to my node, it's just in the description. I would love you guys to connect to my node. I'm pretty well connected to other nodes, so this is good for me and for you as well. So if you will connect, you can write it down in the description. I will connect back to you. So if you would do that, I will connect back to you. But going back to the video, on my Lightning Network node, I created an invoice. So basically, it's a string of characters starting from LNB, and basically it's the Lightning Network invoice. And this invoice, I encoded it, of course, in terms of the QR code, and right now I'm scanning it with my Muun Wallet, with my mobile application of Muun Wallet. So I scanned it, and I went to the tab Pay via Lightning. So there are a few important things on the screen right now. So the amount of the invoice that I asked for was 60,000 satoshis. So 0.0006 Bitcoin. And yeah, it was 60,000 satoshi, so around $5 at this time. But the fee for sending the transaction, it's on the screen, it's called swap fee, was basically 0.007 BTC, so 70,000 satoshi. So it was I was paying $5 to somebody on the Lightning Network, but in the real world, this wallet asked me for paying additional 70,000, so around around $6 worth of fees, so $11 in total. So it don't make much sense. And also, I would have to point out that this transaction was made when the fees were very high. It was around 200 satoshis per byte to send this transaction in the next block, so the fees were very high. And in this wallet, there is no way of basically managing your fees. So I don't know if to do this swap, you need to have the high fee in some way or not. Maybe it's some sort of like custodial way of sending transaction that the creators of Muun, they own the servers who are creating those Lightning Network transactions, but they have to be sure that on-chain transactions are going pretty fast. So probably I would have to ask the creators about that. But of course, the swap fee was very high. It was more than the amount that I would like to pay. But also we can see the Lightning Network fee was zero. Like previously, I had some problems with sending transactions to my node. I don't know why, because I was able to do that from many other wallets, Lightning Network types wallets, but not from Muun. So the Muun team basically connected directly to my node, so there is no fee at all, because like we were connected very, very well. So the Lightning Network fee is of course zero in this case. Like normally it would be around like 2-3 satoshis. So the total transaction was 0.013 bitcoins, and like as I said, it's pretty high fee for sending like one transaction, and I didn't like it. But on the other hand, it's the way of creating transactions. Like if every Bitcoin wallet would have this possibility, probably the traffic on the Lightning Network would be much higher. Also, if there would be an option to basically initialize this transaction with your own fee, like I'm usually paying 3-5 satoshi per byte and it's clearing in like 6 hours per usual. So if I would be able to do that, in this case my fees would be significantly lower, like less than 1,000 satoshis, and yeah, it's the fees would be smaller. So for the people who aren't as technical and they can't set up their own non-custodial services on the Lightning Network, this is some sort of a solution. I won't be bashing this wallet too hard, because I believe this is a some sort of a solution for the people who would like to transact on the Lightning Network, but they don't really have technical skills or they don't want to learn about it. So yeah, in my opinion, that's a viable solution. And I already like see myself like other wallets like Green Address, like Samurai, having this possibility built in, just the submarine swap to Lightning Network. It's non-custodial, it's fairly easy, and it gives the users what they want. So if the user want to use the Lightning Network, of course give them huge warning that the fees will be high, but they will have this possibility. And on the other side, to be the devil's advocate, Lightning Network wasn't created to do this kind of thing. So it wasn't created to do like those one-time transactions from Bitcoin to Lightning Network. Lightning Network was created to open channel to another node. So we are opening channels to other nodes, to some hubs, to our friends. We are opening those channels, and then we can spend up to the point when the channels are empty and we have to rebalance them again on chain. But the current maximum Bitcoin channel on the Lightning Network is 0.16 Bitcoins. So if we would divide it by these 60,000 satoshis, I don't know, it's like 100 times, 500 times, something like that. It's just quick math. It's 100 transactions with the fee of 1 satoshi, or like 5 satoshis max. And yeah, this is Lightning Network. This is why we want to have it like super fast transactions and super cheap transactions on the second layer protocol. Paying Lightning Network invoices, we don't want to basically open the channels every time to the node and transferring those funds, which this wallet is doing. This wallet is basically creating a new hash time lock contract every time we are doing this transfer. And in this particular case, I will show it on the screen in the Blockchain Explorer. There were two transactions. It wasn't one transaction. There were two transactions that were done on the on-chain, on Bitcoin chain, to create this Lightning Network transaction. So we had to transact two times to create this one. So in my opinion, it's a gimmick, but I think that will drive the popularity of the Lightning Network. I would love to have a talk with creators of this wallet, Dario Snydermanis and Federico Bond. Please follow them on Twitter if you are interested in this wallet more. I would love to speak with them because this is very nice hacky solution. Of course, there are those two sides, like you shouldn't do the Lightning Network transfers like from the on-chain to pay for the invoice, but on the other hand, it's the better user experience. So yeah, there are two sides of this story, so that's why I would love to speak with them. And they created this very nice hacky solution. And just to show you how this transaction was cleared on my node, so it was cleared almost instantaneously. So just when I pressed the send button on my mobile phone, it went through like the normal Lightning Network transaction. Basically, the transaction was made on chain that had some time lock contract that was unlocked by this coordinator who sent the Lightning Network transaction and got the secret from it. So basically it went very fast, in like a few seconds, and as we can see on the screen right now, it's settled as true. So yeah, it was basically paid very fast, instantaneously. So yeah, pros for that. I would see the pros of it, like to pay for some coffee. We don't have our normal Lightning Network wallet or something like that. There are some pros, of course, to this solution, and as I said, I'm really interested in how well it can be developed as some sort of the gimmick for other wallets who are only Bitcoin wallets. I guess that's the end of this video. Please give me some feedback, both on the Muun Wallet. Do you like it, or is it some sort of the gimmick for the Bitcoin wallets? Or maybe it's the viable solution. And of course, give me a feedback as well. Hit the like button underneath if you like this video. If you didn't like it, hit the dislike button. And let me know in the comment section what did I do wrong in this video. Please subscribe to my channel, of course, because new videos are coming. More videos about BTC Pay Server, Lightning Network, as always. Maybe some new additions to my Raspi Blitz tutorials, new interviews, new videos. It's all going to this channel. So yeah, please subscribe if you are interested about everything what's going on with Bitcoin on more technical side and Lightning Network. I love these things. And basically, I'm exploring them with you, so I'm just documenting what I learned in my journey. So thanks for watching this video, and have a great day. Bye.